This is my family farm, 1,000 feet above sea level in the Durham Dales. I'm Matt Baker, and I grew up here with my mum Janice and dad Mike. But weeks ago, my mum, the shepherdess, was involved in a freak accident.
This is where it happened, just in this pen here.
You reach a time in your life when you think, I just really can't do this anymore.
So the farm is at a crossroads, and we need to make some big changes. With my daughter, Molly.
It's a little bit smelly.
Son, Luke.
It's so cool.
And wife, Nicola.
The hole's definitely bigger than it was.
It's going to be a challenging few months.
Let's pull some force out.
Securing the farm's future.
Yes, a new fence.
Some nice ones here.
We'll be off around the country, buying easier to manage sheep.
Sheep delivery!
I've passed myself, I'm like a little kid.
And with the help of some friends.
Them donkeys are laughing at you, Gordon. I think they would be.
Changing the way the farm runs.
Hey, now shall we go left or right?
You're beautiful, Joey, you are.
I feel like I'm taking off in a rocket.
Hey, wait.
Are you going to put your hand warmer down and go and get a chicken?
Whoa, look at the hill!
What an adventure it's going to be.
Oh, no. Welcome to our farm in the Dales.
We've already made some big changes. To make life easier for Mum and Dad, we've dug out all around the farm and built a new road. We've renovated buildings and relocated our animals to make them easier to get to.
Oh, sweetie pie, hello.
And we've pulled out and replaced the old fencing to keep everything where it should be.
Well done, everyone.
Mum is slowly getting better.
Yes.
And the farm is taking on a whole new lease of life. At the heart of our organic farm are sheep. But we've been making changes to our flock too, and our plan to buy easier to manage breeds that can thrive 1,000 feet up is taking shape. In changing the heavier Hampshires, so far we've been to the lakes for the Herdwicks.
Yeah, she's lovely, she is.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Pop her in.
That's the best one you've picked.
And to Snowdonia for the Black Welsh Mountain Sheep.
What do you reckon?
I really like them, they're so cool.
They're beautiful,
aren't they? I think they're going to be perfect for your mum.
The new breeds are settling in well, alongside a flock that we've had on the farm for years, and the very sheep that inspired us to go down this route.
I'm going to put this block down.
Right, there's the...
Yep.
We got it.
These are the Hebrideans. They cope so well. Up here.
Come on.
There you go.
It's quite wild and woolly this morning. Literally.
I love these sheep.
I know you do. You've always liked them, even when you were really quite young.
Yeah.
When you got them with the dog.
They're so hardy, you know, and as the name suggests, you know, they're from the Outer Hebrides, but you get the sense that they really are an ancient breed. I love their presence here on this farm because they feel certainly like they can cope with where we're at, you know, such a high altitude. And yet they can thrive, they can flourish. But come lambing time, you know, they'll much prefer to be on their own. You'll see a ewe kind of just toddle off, maybe into, you know, just a bit of the undergrowth or what have you. And then an hour later, she'll come back with a lamb or two. And breeds like this are definitely the way forward for my mum.
But they still need caring for. And I brought them in to do an important job that mum would normally do.
All of our different flocks get fluked.
Give them the best possible chance of getting through the wet months.
Fluke is a horrible thing. This like hideous sort of parasite that passes through snails and it lives in a really kind of damp environment. So this time of year, you've got to be so, so careful.
If something as a sheep farmer, you've really got to battle against and protect your flock. So the medication's in this bottle here and you give them it through this gun. All you do is give a little squeeze on the sides of the mouth, shove in the gun, they'll swallow it like that, marker on the back end,
The key's to try and get the dot as neat as possible. You can see when one's run away, it's just got like a stripe all the way down its back.
Now, these are the ones that we really want to protect, the little lambs. They're not quite as robust as Mum.
It's not just livestock that we're attached to, as we've always farmed with wildlife in mind. We have thousands of trees on the farm, and Dad is very sentimental about them.
When anyone in our family passes on, I always plant a tree in their memory. And when I walk by that tree, I think of that person. This one, like for John, who was my very best friend, I've got one for him, and I've got one for all. Auntie Harvey, she's there with Uncle Charlie and Auntie Annie, or everybody. And when I walk by, I think it's nicer than just a bunch of flowers.
Well, now we want to plant something for him that my parents will both be able to enjoy. So we're going to create an orchard. The old hill garden is the ideal spot. It's sheltered and south-facing and ready for a new lease of life.
Well, how big is the area? How big? Because then we can work out how many trees we can get in.
I'm going to say 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14!
How far is it that way?
16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13. 12. 12. Should we do 12 by 12 square then?
Yeah, I think 12 by 12 square. Put three there, and then a couple there.
Perfect.
You can get your little thing out and draw a little plan.
So with my little thing, I've sketched out a design. We'll make a level grass path through the centre for easy harvesting, cutting the hedges in a way that allows in the light but keeps out the wind. The perfect home for a selection of specially chosen apple trees that my dad will love.
Ready?
Yeah, go for it.
All I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a tiny bit off the top. What's it like to walk on?
It's very nice.
Could go wonky.
The trees arrived. Ooh.
Lovely.
These are all the beautiful apple trees for the orchard for Mike. So he's in the house, so he can't see them at the moment.
Come with it.
Yeah, that's great. That'll be brilliant there. Thank you. Right, let's rip it off. There we go, look. Be careful with them because they're all wedged in nicely.
There's one.
Hang on.
There we are, look.
Ribston pippin. Careful.
Ah.
That's it, get it through the gap. Well done, Luke. So what Matthew's doing at the moment is we're trying to cut some of the big branches back just to let more light in. Mike's always dreamed of having an orchard and hopefully we can surprise him with this and he'll be really happy.
The youngest inhabitants on the farm are now approaching 6 weeks old.
All right, I'm going to tell you a little secret now. Cairn Terriers can change colour with every season, but if you just look under the tail, just there, look, he's going to be really light, and that never changes.
And in preparation for life in their new homes, they need to be introduced to as many different experiences as possible.
So have you got your sweeping brush ready? Do it slowly. That's it. We just have to watch them with cables, Luke, if there's any cables anywhere. Hey, watch out, here they comes the roadrunner.
A job that's great fun, but also very important.
See, look, Nicola, can you do the bag? Ooh, what's that noise? Good boy, Radley. It's really good to have lots of praise when they're being clever.
Clever boy.
It's after the brush now, look. Here's your brother, that's Brandon, that's a big boy of the litter. And you think you're brave, but not really.
It's you.
This is Dora the Explorer. This is your favourite, Luke.
Hi.
Final 10 days when they get between 6 and 8 weeks. It's difficult. And the herring round the living room or running up and down the hallway. This year with my leg and my knee, it has been more challenging than I expected it would be. But they've been a really good litter. Was Molly looking at socks?
It's Radley. What are you doing, Radley?
Come on, get in.
They've got so much energy, haven't they?
I think the best way to describe a Cairn Terrier is every day is a party day.
We've moved the pygmy goats, Brocky and Bourbon, into the donkey stables to make it easier for Mum to feed up. With plenty of space in their own paddock, I've taken the bold step of organising a surprise.
I'm just on my way out to do a little bit of shopping. Nobody knows what I'm going for, and I'm in the truck for good reason, because what I'm about to collect absolutely stinks. Oh, boy, oh. What have we got ourselves into here?
I've called the family over to the stable yard for a special delivery.
Matthew just rang me and said, can you put the goats in the donkey yard? Because I've got something to show everybody. I've got no idea what that is, but the donkeys know something's going on because they've come up to have a look as well. So the donkeys are here, the family are here, everybody's here. I hope it's a good surprise.
But it doesn't really matter what us lot think about the new arrival. It's all about the opinion of the nanny goats.
He's smiling, look. What has he got?
I have no idea.
Is that all right?
Now, I didn't think it would be a live thing.
Oh. What's he got?
Right, OK.
You got the bales out, well
done. I did, yeah, I got the bales. I was thinking, why do we need the bales?
Well, I'm going to make a ramp up there like that.
You think we should close the gate, or are we OK?
I'm going to make you a T-shirt with that on. And then you can just open your coat.
This animal absolutely stinks.
I can actually smell it.
Can you? Right, Dan, you protect me, Mum.
I will.
Kids, come round here. Molly here. Anything could happen here. He's quite
wow,
a wild
he's
chap.
He's beautiful.
He is, isn't he?
Oh, it's
oh my word.
Good
boy. Right, Nicola, can you just get the top of this?
Yeah.
I'm going to go in and just see what I can. Hopefully, he won't run at me. Just keep it down. Now drop that. Drop it down behind me.
Yeah.
Drop it down behind me.
Okay, nice and quiet, nice and quiet.
That's it. Good. I'm just gonna grab his horns. Good lad. Good, I got him.
Okay.
Yeah, lift it up now.
Come on, boy.
Oh, Mr. Billy.
Busted nose and two black eyes.
Just watch his feet in that gap.
Steady, steady.
Ooh. There we are, look.
Steady, steady.
Oh, my word.
Isn't he lovely?
Oh,
he's
a perfect colour.
Ready?
Isn't he lovely?
There you are. Oh, it just fits through. And there you are with your girls.
Look at him.
Oh, he's cool, isn't he? What a dude.
He looks like that movie person. Who's that?
Gandalf.
Gandalf.
Yes. Oh, look, they seem quite excited, look.
They want to show him the paddock.
Oh, he's going to be perfect. Fantastic.
He's a real smart aleck, isn't he? The girls seem to like him anyhow.
There's a new kid in town. Yeah, exactly.
Donkeys are running about like mad.
All right. Donkeys are going nuts. Shall we get you in the paddock, sir? I'm going to open this up and let him run straight through.
There you go, Billy.
Whee!
There we are. He looks at home there, Janice.
Oh, he's going to be perfect. Can you imagine? So we've got chocolate brown, white, black and white. They'll be so pretty, won't they? Hopefully, maybe tricoloured.
Oh, that'll be amazing.
Black, white and brown on.
Oh, he looks great, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does look nice in there.
There they are, all together, love.
So, fingers crossed, come the spring...
Little pygmy goes. Spring.
The pygmy goat stablemates, our miniature Mediterranean donkeys, have been on the farm for the last decade. Originally from the mountains of Sardinia, they were bred as shepherds' helpers and companions. But Augustine, Winifred, Sophia, Luna and Pavlova have a much more relaxed existence in our valley.
Right, sweetheart. Should we just let them walk out and then re-catch them out here?
A regular visitor to our farm is John, our farrier. We keep a close eye on their tiny feet, as donkeys don't wear metal shoes. so he comes to file down their hooves every couple of months. But today, he has something much more serious to tend to. Augustine came to us when she was a foal, 8 years ago, and in that time she's never had anything wrong with her, so it was a shock to see her struggling to walk. She's already been treated for a rare abscess in her hoof by the vet, and John's going to check on her progress.
She wasn't putting any weight on at all, was she, Mum, before?
No, nothing.
You can see the dark black hole?
Yeah.
Track's going right the way up its hoof wall.
She had a really sort of swollen knee, didn't she? It'd gone right up there.
If it doesn't get released, it will travel up the leg. The pressure's been released.
Mm-hmm.
So now it can drain, free flow drain out.
Yeah.
And now we're going to put some copper sulfate in it again, and hopefully it'll antiseptic and harden it up.
Right. So do I need to do exactly what you're doing here?
Change it again in 2 days' time.
I
just put it in the swab rather than, like,
so
it soaks through rather than it being direct onto it.
I see. And does that copper sulfate then just destroy any infection?
Yeah.
Well, she's doing well.
She's been very good.
And that'll do her.
There we go.
Yeah. She's better off, I guess, just kept in the yard on the hard standing.
Yeah.
For now, just feed her in here and what have you. And...
Yeah. I'll communicate with the vet and then see how she is and whether she needs to be seen again.
This morning it's been a worry and a little bit of weight on it. She's a bit like me. I think she just came out in sympathy, I think, the pair of us. She's now got a little silver shoe on, haven't you? Little Cinderella.
We've been changing our flock for sheep that are easier to tend to 1,000 feet up. So I'm heading to Willie Thompson's farm in the Scottish Borders to look at some Cheviots, a breed that thrives at high altitude, lambs easily on the hills, and has incredible wool. Perfect for my mum and our farm.
Willie! How are you doing?
I'm all right, you?
All good? Good to see you all. Tell you what, it's nippy on the tops today. Snow up there, it's amazing.
Are you good, Johnny, up?
Do you know, I did, yeah, thank you. Very, very good. It just started raining, perfect.
That's what we like, ideal. Mind you, if we're getting sheep that can thrive in this weather, that's why I'm here, man.
That's what you're after.
That's why I'm here, yeah, exactly.
Sit down.
These are absolute beauties, Willie. So they normally wear...
Right on the very top that we kind of see, Matt, it's the top hill runs to 1,550 feet, and it's in that gloom of mist in the background.
And what a place to exist, Willie. I mean, look at where we are. It's incredible, isn't it?
Right, family's been here since 1941. I'm fourth generation, so, and the Cheviots came with them in 1941, so.
And how many do you run up here then?
We've got 1,400 breeding ewes.
It's quite something to be in the Cheviots with the Hill Cheviots.
We farm a total of 1,600 acres.
Wow.
3 miles for here to the end of the...
3 miles? That's amazing. And do you lamb them up here and everything?
Lambed up here, yep.
Everything?
Yep.
Oh, they look lovely, don't they, when they run as a flock? You see their ears bobbing up and down?
With a Cheviot, you want them nice and white at the heads, and no wool running sort of down their inside their back legs or too far up their cheeks or that. You want a sort of a clean line. In the late 1400s, mid 1500s, there was merino put in Cheviots on white-faced sheep in these hills. It vastly improved the wool quality. So, you know, through the 1700s, when wool was worth a lot of money, there was a lot of money made off of Cheviot sheep in the Cheviot hills.
My mum's at a time in her life, because of what's happened to her with her accident, you know, she needs something that's going to be able to help her through the winter as much as she's going to help them through the winter. I think we're onto a winner here. Right, let's go and have a look and see what you put to one side then, shall we?
Yep.
I'm excited. Okay, now then, girls. Oh, wow, they all look fantastic, actually. What do you think, Laura?
I always choose a head and then look for the rest, so...
Yeah.
Which I don't know whether is right or wrong, but, yeah.
But that's your way.
Fair enough.
Look at this. This is unbelievable up here. Gosh, look at all the rosettes. But which one are you most proud of?
This row here.
Oh, the young handlers.
Yep.
Is that you guys? Yeah. Oh, isn't that wonderful? Well, congratulations, all of you who've won those.
The Queen's Cup's a good one as well, isn't it?
Yep, I would...
Hey, that's quite something, isn't it, to hear Dad say that? Of all of those wonderful things up there, he's proud of yours. Right, girls. Who would like to come to Durham?
You're nice. You're nice. Hey, you put a good bunch together here, Willie. This is tough. This is tough.
If it's any help, that's my three what I think are my best.
Are these ones?
Yeah.
Right.
So if you can...
Match those.
Match those.
Sorry, sweetheart.
Oh, no.
It's not going to be you.
OK, my dear,
I'm afraid you're not coming to Durham either.
Yep, yep, that would be my next one.
Yeah.
Don't worry, he's a quick learner.
Oh.
One more. That one there, yeah, right in the...
Blue tags, right in the middle.
Middle.
Double blue tag.
Do you want me to get it, James? Are you good? You going in? Straight in there.
Got her. Good lad.
It's a lively one. It's a wrestler. Good lad. Thank you. I can see why he won all those trophies now. Excellent. So there we have it. The chosen 10.
That's it. Nice starter pack.
Thank you. So you're just giving them a little scan there.
Yeah, just reading their tags. And then...
I can't believe this conveyor belt system. It's unbelievable.
Good.
Right, team, let's go for a trip.
Hopefully Janice will like them. They're an even bunch.
And it'd be good to see them back and compete maybe at a local show.
Perfect. Well, thank you all for your help. Much appreciated.
There we go.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Oh, it's a lovely night. Red sky at night, cheery at delight.
I've been to the Cheviot Hills to buy the latest new flock for the future of our farm.
Hello! I've been waiting for you.
Mum can't wait to see them, so she's meeting me down at the hay shed with a tipple to celebrate.
Cheviot's mum.
Yes, I know.
They've come to say hello.
Oh, look, hello, girls. Gosh, you look rather smart.
Ready?
Yeah.
Here you go, girls.
Good girls. Woo! Come on. Hey, everybody's gone. Ooh, they look really bright.
Bright-eyed.
Yeah, they're quite pretty, aren't they?
Oh, very.
I really like them.
Perfect.
Chin chin.
Cheers, Mum.
Chin chin to the Cheviots.
For 20 years, my dad's old car has been rusting away as an eyesore at the side of the farm. It's been weighing heavy on his mind.
It's caused me a lot of sleepless nights.
Yeah.
Because he's just ashamed to see it go, you know, fall to bit, and I couldn't do anything about it.
So a couple of weeks ago, we dug it out, loaded it up, and took it to a local restoration garage to see if anything could be done to save it.
I so wanted to go again. I just hope she comes back.
After a few weeks in the garage, I'm about to hear the verdict. It would mean the world if it could be saved, but I'm not holding out much hope.
There she is. Oh, hang on, there's someone in the driving seat.
It's Keith. Keith's our mechanic.
How are you, Keith? Yeah! God, I tell you what, that takes me back, hearing that engine. That really does. That's just hit me in the heart, that has. Oh, my word, he's coming out! Come on, Keith! Yeah. God, it's working and everything's... No way! The lights work! Well, that one does.
That's indicated.
Oh, that one, that's the air! Well, I tell you what, you lads are wizards. You must be. You seem to start first call.
Yeah, that's not been started at all today.
No way.
She goes, I was amazed myself when it started. You? I was.
Can I open up the bonnet and have a look?
Yeah, certainly.
Should open up.
I mean, she sounds healthy.
It sounds really
good. It sounds really sweet, yeah.
Really good.
How difficult was it then, Keith?
I started by draining the fuel off, because it was stale fuel anyway. Had the carburetor, the bits,
because in the bottom of the carburetor, it was full of sediment after standing that long. It had gone solid.
My dad's not going to believe it. My mother's not going to believe it. I tell you, I think my mother was hoping that it would disappear.
Hoping it wouldn't go.
It's amazing. I mean, I expected to come in here and sort of, I don't know, have a poke around underneath or whatever and just have a look at some holes. I never...
You still do that.
I never in a million years expect you to reverse it off the ramp. It's incredible. I think what we need to do is show it back to my dad, don't we? And say, look, Dad, this is the story. What do you reckon? What's the next chapter? He's going to be amazed, Keith. Oh, God, can we turn her over again? Here we go. There she goes! What's making me feel more emotional is knowing what this is going to mean to me, Dad. We waved off the car from the top of the farm, and I think he thought to himself, cancer, that ain't coming back. And, you know, he's beaten himself up for a long time about the condition that it's in. And I think he'll be delighted to hear she's doing everything in her power to get back onto the road.
Me and Nicola have made a good start in turning the old hill garden into a low-maintenance orchard, a place for Mum and Dad to come and enjoy the view and the produce. It's something they've always wanted, but never got round to.
The idea is that this is actually a grass path, so we don't really want to bring up any shale or anything to drop in here.
It's definitely flatter, isn't it, this?
Over time, it's just a really nice grass-levelled path.
What's that one? That's the Cox's.
Yeah.
This one's a Ribston Pippin. Let's put that one there. Oh. This is my favourite one, Lady of the Lake. Sounds epic, I love the name. The Lady of the Lake there, look. Please? I can't wait for your dad to see it. Make his dreams come true.
Let's get the lady in the lake.
Yeah. The soil looks good.
It's lovely. I'm so pleased that we're doing this for me dad. He loves his trees and he loves his apples. And the thought of him just coming along here, walking this lovely little path, picking a few apples, looking at the view, that's brilliant.
Yes, we put a sprinkle of compost. Just put a bit of the root growing.
Nice and hard, go on, harder. Give it some beans.
Brilliant.
Lady of the Lake.
Lady of the Lake's in.
First one in.
It's good, I'll just give it a little water in.
Through time, botanists and experts have found out that you can actually graft a fruit onto a different root system, so that some trees have the information that they grow really long or tall and what have you, and others will grow squat and like little bushes. So the type that we've gone for here with the rootstock is something that's not going to grow too tall, so that when my dad comes in, he'll be able to get stuff that's kind of at head height. He won't have to bend down. Plenty of worms down here as well. Let's see how you fit.
The transformation of the old hill garden is complete. Time to see what Mum and Dad think.
Welcome to your new orchard.
Look at this.
So there's 6 apple trees and a plum.
Wow.
Gosh, don't they look
And you've left all the names on for us to
Well,
see.
Actually,
oh,
I've made some little things.
What
so,
a fantastic idea.
So the Lady of the Lake.
Yeah.
That's this one here.
Oh, they're
that's
lovely
Lady
little
of the Lake.
Markers, those.
This is a Cox's. This one's a Ribston Pippin.
Oh,
that's
like
there.
The
this one's Beauty of Bath.
Oh, that's definitely
not Beauty
me.
In the Bath. Beauty of Bath. Beauty of Bath. So oh, this one's green sleeves.
Wow, what a combination then.
You know, I have apples every day, don't you? At least one, sometimes
well,
two.
Well, exactly. So now you've got a place where you can come, walk down there, pick your apples.
Away you go.
This can stay long, this grass, and you can just mow this middle bit.
Isn't that lovely? What a lovely idea.
And then when it grows, you should be able to walk through your trees.
It doesn't end there, because we've actually got some other trees that are in the process of being grafted and grown.
Baker's delicious. And so what's that then?
It's an apple tree.
Brilliant. Really lovely. Thank you. After waiting about 30 years, we finally got our little orchard.
I love trees. I mean, you know that. And to sit in a tranquil place like this and you've actually got the fruit of the tree, couldn't be better, could it?
Mum's been really successful breeding and showing her chickens. But there hasn't been any poultry shows for the past year, and Mum wouldn't have been able to go anywhere because of her accident. So we've decided to hold our own little courtyard competition, with my dad as head judge. The first task for us all is to choose our entry.
Bubble!
So I've chosen Bubble, and I've worn a gold headband because gold represents the win.
I think I might go for John, because I think Grandad will like his tail a bit more. And Houdini's quite old now, so... And John hasn't really shown before, so I think this will be his debut.
I'm going for the cutest, smallest, most gorgeousest little chick ever. So this is my plan. They're about the same sort of size, really.
The thing is...
Sorry I'm late, everyone.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
I had a slight issue grabbing my wine dot.
Wow, wine dot.
Yeah, I just love the feathers.
Yeah.
Oh, hey,
oh. Oh, oh, here we go.
Hello, everyone.
Nanny goes for the biggest and the best look. Look at that
look. Are you gonna put your hand warmer down and go and get a chicken? Well, right. Let's get prepping.
Right, OK.
You're so cute when you're fluffy.
Now then, what you do with a tail is you puff it up like that, look. That's it, that's it. You ready, John? We can do this, man. We can do this. She's looking quite good there, Molly. She doesn't need to look too good, you know.
Hold still for me, dear. Steady.
Can you get your hairdryer on?
Just do a quick fluff up.
Let's get that rosette.
Time for the judging.
Welcome to the ultimate chicken show.
This looks like a big fair hat. Matches your hair. Yes,
just look. It looks like my mother, don't you think?
Yes, I think it looks like your mother.
It's not as cute as this one, though. Yeah. I mean, look, this one's cuter.
No, she's still asleep. She's still asleep.
Dad, look at the feathers on that. Look at the feathers.
Look at the cuteness on that one.
Look at him.
I know. Well,
he's awesome.
This is difficult. Right, let's have a look and see. It's time to judge. Because somebody's got to win and somebody's got to lose.
Oh!
Look at those!
Right, cheekiest chicken. Cheeky chicken.
Ooh, Roland got cheekiest.
Finest feathers. Well, there's no doubt about that because that one's got the finest feathers.
Yes! Yay. Well done, Rosie.
The fluffiest chicken. Fluffy chicken.
Wow.
Ooh, Molly, well done.
A future champion. Well, although it's been asleep most of the time, I think that's definitely a future champion.
Yay!
Well done. Whoop,
whoop, well whoop, done. Whoop.
Well then, best in show has got to go to John.
Yay! Wow. Well done, John.
Well done, John.
Well done, John. Well done, John.
Well done,
gets the cup.
Yay!
Best in show cup.
You celebrate. That's your champagne, John.
There you are, John.
Well done, John.
Mum's not the only one with a bad leg. 8-year-old Augustine has been treated for an abscess in her hoof and has been struggling to walk. But with no vet or farrier here today, it's my turn to continue the treatment.
Clever girl. Oh, steady way. Good girl. Whoops. Clever girl.
Once we can get this gaffer off, see where we are.
It's nice and clean in there anyway, actually. It's done a good job. I know it's a bit of a pain to get off. Hopefully the little poultice thing that's been on will have drawn out some more of the abscess.
I'm just trying to be so careful.
I know.
I don't want to pull where it's sore. I don't want to use the scissors where I don't have to, just in case you can. She's leaning up against me, bless her.
There's no rush, is she?
Mm. Oh. Hey, sweetheart.
Well, that's really good.
This is the bit where she'll jump.
You...
Have a look.
Oh, that looks lovely and clean.
Yeah?
Happy with that. There's hardly anything on that bit of gauze that you've chucked out.
A few days ago, when John came up and did this, that was it was very sore in there. And there was a bit of blood and what have you in there. Now it's dried up. It looks very, very clean.
It's done a good job, hasn't it?
Sweetheart. Back in the hall.
Get a nice clean bit.
Thank you. I'll put it round that way.
Dr. Baker. Nurse Janice. It's all right, sweetheart.
She's doing great.
She's fantastic. It's obviously not as painful. I think we all deserve a nice cup of coffee after this. You've been very good.
That, my darling, is you done for now. Who's that, sweetheart?
There you go, Teeny. Mm-hmm. Augustine, go and see. There, she's putting a bit more weight on it there, though.
Yeah.
Oh, what a sweetheart.
Being surrounded by nature, you never know what you're going to see or when. The other night, Luke and I were out on the tractor, and we were joined by something special.
The barn owl comes in.
And we want to give them every opportunity to thrive here.
We've got a couple of owl boxes because the males will choose to roost in a different tree to the females. So in order to accommodate for them, we've actually got an owl box in that oak over there and another one here. Sadly, this one isn't in the best possible state. And to give them the best possible chance, we need to replace this one and do a bit of work on it. Yeah.
There's no bottom in that.
Not ideal for an owl to roost in.
Let's build a new owl box.
I mean, obviously, you can just buy one of these. It's much more fun to utilise bits and pieces that we've got lying around.
Our triangular owl box is designed to keep the weather out and the barn owl chicks in.
Lucky owls, that's what I say. Good. Getting there, Dad.
Yeah. Right, now we need some screws. Now, I've got some good screws here.
I've got some good screws here.
Well, I've got some good screws.
Mine are better than yours, I'm telling you.
Well, I've got some better than yours.
Owl chicks are very active, so I'm cutting a door at the top to stop them falling out.
You look like an owl.
Good, perfect, that's it.
Good.
Yeah.
To keep the nest material dry and warm, we're using roofing felt to weatherproof the sides.
Beginning to look like an owl box, this.
Ta-da!
There we are.
There we are.
Well, I think you've done a good job there, son.
I think we did a good job.
Yeah, excellent. Excellent.
Eddie lives across the valley, and he has a weekend job helping out on the farm. He's brought over his barn owl, Joey, to try out the nesting box for size.
Go on.
Is she nervous? Oh, she's beautiful, isn't she?
Come on, get on the hook.
There you are, sweetheart.
Isn't she gorgeous?
So how old is Joey then, Eddie?
She's 2.5 years now.
Right.
Yeah, she was... I got her from a guy in Liverpool when she was 3 weeks old. She's never been wild.
Right, Eddie, what do you think of this then? My dad and I have been a bit busy, so...
I think it looks great. It's got a good perch on the top and the felt looks like it's going to fare really well. You want to go up, Joey?
Oh!
Hey, Joey, you're a star.
You get yourself in there, stick your hand out and see if she'll jump on it.
Yeah.
Oh, Joey.
You're beautiful, Joey, you are.
Well, it's something to see you, Joey. Thanks for coming over and checking out the owl box. I guess we can put the back on and put it up now.
Yeah.
With our new box ready for the barn owls to use, the stage is set for young in the spring. Hopefully thriving here with a mixture of habitats to explore. The farm is a haven for wildlife. A few years ago, we dug a pond in our ancient woodlands to harness some of the water that runs off the hills. And now we want to improve the surrounding habitats to create even more biodiversity.
This needs to come up. So if we plug this, the water level will rise and the bottom pond will be bigger.
Yeah.
Cut that out there, create a beach here.
Yeah.
With stones and all that sort of stuff.
So it's not so much of a steep bank.
Yeah, exactly. I need to get in here first with a mini digger. Do you think that bridge will hold?
There's only one way to find out, I suppose.
I didn't bring me swimming trunks. If you hear any cracking, let me know. Right, we've got this far. Don't fall in. Yes, we're over. Just making a bit of a flatter area here for now for this beach.
Nice soil, that.
All right.
That's good, yeah. Yeah, a little bit wider.
About there?
Yeah, about there.
So this pond is actually fed from a field drain. We're just adding other habitats, you know, for frogs and for toads and for the dragonfly and things that will lay their eggs or spawn within the beach.
There's lots of, like, little insects that go in there and, like, watery nymphs and things that just go in the pebbles. He loves going around on diggers like this.
Have a dance. Jump up and down on it.
It's a good job having a big lunch.
Right, let's have a look. So we're going to put a pipe in there now.
Yeah.
How this will work, I'm going to cover this all in soil. And then the water, it'll come up to here, and as soon as it starts to overflow, it'll go all the way down this pipe, down the drain, and then continue. So, you just need to stay there. Don't move, and I'll try not to cover you in soil.
OK.
Right, stand back.
You never know a binny.
Start raining again. Have you got a brolly?
No. You're nice and dry. You're all right. All right, that should be a bit more solid for the stone. We're just flattening it off a little bit, and then we've got a buggy full of stone that we're going to make into the beach habitat.
Fingers crossed the bridge holds, Moles. Fingers crossed. Everyone got a shovel? Sit. We'll get all sorts of wonderful little dragonfly larvae in here. And then we'll have a nice little beach way down there. I'll have to squeeze it all down. And then as the water level raises up, it'll just lap up onto the beach.
Molly, you were talking about deckers.
It's going to be lovely, Molly. Frogs and toads enjoying a little bit of sunshine.
Right, kids, don't find either a stone or a piece of wood that you think something would like to live in.
Is that just to get rid of the kids?
This will be ideal for wildlife, just to come down and take a drink.
A stone.
Hop. One, two, three.
That's almost like a little bench.
And go drop.
Yeah, that looks nice.
Drop it down. What you could do is put it so it overlaps, and then that's like a
cave.
Cave, yeah. Made to measure.
That's a good one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's great. How's it feel? Come and have a seat, love.
I will. In the spring, when everything starts to grow around it, it'll be brilliant.
Has anyone got a fishing rod?
I don't think we'll get many fish in here, do you?
Our woodlands are also home to rooks and crows that come here every evening to roost. Their arrival is always a magnificent display.
Woodlands have a magic of their own at this time of the night, don't they?
They certainly do. I personally think the fairy lights help, though, don't you, Molly?
It's casserole cookout time.
Yay! There
we go. It's fizzing beautifully. Whoa!
Look at that, Nanny. Thank you.
It's definitely ready.
Fine.
Careful, kiddiewinks, because that's going to be roasting.
It's going to be lovely and warm, that look.
Oh, I'm loving the beautiful crockery.
Tea's up. There you go, Dad.
Watch out, it's red hot.
Thank you.
Got it?
Yeah, I'll leave that on my knee to warm it up a bit.
This looks lovely.
Thank you.
Thanks to all your hard work, and thanks to Molly and Luke for pitching in. Back to everyone.
They've worked really hard.
They have.
I'm so pleased with them.
A lot of change, but I have to say, all for the better. Don't you think so, Mike?
I do.
It feels like there's a new energy.
Yeah, it's rejuvenating in a nice way. So that's a little lesson in life, Kiddywinks, that every cloud has a silver lining if you're prepared to look for it and work for it.
You've made the best of a bad situation.
You have. That's good, Molly. Well done.
Do you know what I'm looking forward to?
Go on.
To see what's next.
Well, Dad, next time, the old courtyard will be transformed.
You got a sinking feeling.
Dad.
He's sizing me up.
I'll be wrestling rams in the Lake District.
Good lad. There's a good boy.
And Dad gets back behind the wheel.
Right, brings back memories, does this.
Feels like when you used to pick me up from school.
You haven't been a naughty boy again, have you?